And anything that was thought to be, quote, natural was a throwback to ignorant village life in Hungary and Russia. So I was raised as a believer with a technology orientation. And in my family, being a believer meant doing everything to the maximum. My parents' attitude was that every medication, every pill, must mean better health. Now, my father, when he was in his early 50s, had a massive heart attack and died. He may have died because the neighborhood we were living in did not have a hospital with an intensive care unit or a cardiologist present, and he did not get intensive cutting-edge treatment. Possibly he could have survived, perhaps not. But this experience reinforced my belief in intensive interventions. And that maximalist mindset extended not only to heart disease, but basically to all of medicine. And my choice in the 1970s to become a hematologist and oncologist fit with this maximalist mindset, this point of view. So bone marrow transplant, which I trained in those years, was the most intensive treatment and was able to save the lives of people with leukemia and lymphoma who otherwise would have died. So my medical mind is that of a maximalist and a believer.
So I had a different kind of upbringing. I was the first child in my family, and when I was a baby, the doctor explained to my parents that the new scientific way to feed a baby was every 4 hours by the clock. And my dad, who was an engineer, was very enthusiastic about applying scientific principles to child rearing, so he made a very detailed chart for my mother so that she could check off every 4 hours when she fed me, and then he went to work. And my mother, who was at home with a screaming baby all day, didn't take too long to figure out that maybe it might be a better idea to feed me when I was hungry. So my dad came home and wanted to see the chart and was just absolutely scandalized that my mother had deviated from the instructions. And he said, "How can you not follow the advice of the doctors, the experts?" And her response was that of a doubter. Doctors don't know everything. So my parents were ahead of their time with respect to a healthy lifestyle. They never smoked. They were avid exercisers. My dad used to get us up early in the morning, my sisters and I, to do the Royal Canadian Air Force exercises. And my mom had us eating whole wheat bread, which in the 1950s was not a particularly tasty thing to have to eat. And we weren't allowed to have soda except on special occasions. And my parents have had the good fortune, either by virtue of their genetics or lifestyle, to live long and healthy lives with a minimum of medical intervention. My dad is now 91 this year, my mom 86, and they're still very healthy, work out in the gym every day. And this background has contributed to my minimalist doubter orientation. So Jerry's a maximalist and a believer, while I'm a minimalist and a doubter. And we maintain these same mindsets about our own health, despite going to similar medical schools. He went to Columbia, I went to Harvard, and then we trained at the very same hospital for our residency training, Mass General in Boston. So why are we telling you this? We want to point it out to show you that doctors and experts have medical mindsets, and this can impact the advice that we give. But of course, making decisions about treatment must also consider the evidence, the numbers, data from clinical trials. Shouldn't these numbers give you the answers that you need to figure out what's best?
So one of the first patients we spoke to is a woman we call Susan Powell. All the patients we talk with you about today are real, but we changed their names for confidentiality.